Philippine and U.S. troops carry out joint relief operations in storm-hit province of Cagayan. The activity was witnessed by the Philippine Defense Secretary, Gilbert Chudoro, and Philippine Armed Forces Chief, General Romeo Bonner Jr. The soldiers at Cagayan's Lalo Airport unloaded over 1,000 family food packs sent to typhoon-hit communities in the Uga and Calayan Islands. Now, the facility is among the new sites to be jointly used by Filipino and American troops under the Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement, or EDCA. Secretary Chudoro called for faster upgrades to the Lalo Airport that would boost its role in defense and humanitarian efforts.
We'd like to thank our United States partners for coming into our assistance, because our air assets are totally committed, not only here in Northern Luzon, in Central Luzon, and in Mindanao also. I saw for myself the need to speed up the development of these Philippine bases in order to serve a total national security picture of our country.
Massive flooding remains a problem in some provinces in the aftermath of recent typhoons. In Pampanga, over 200 villages remain inundated. Now, meanwhile, in Bulacan, residents in Bugo village in Kalumpit are also dealing with power outages on top of insufficient food and water supply. The widespread flooding prompted senators to question the effectiveness of government's flood control measures. Despite criticisms, the Marcos administration is asking for higher budget for flood control projects next year at 215 billion pesos. Meanwhile, the damage brought by Typhoon Egay and the southwest monsoon to road infrastructure climbs to 7 billion pesos. The Department of Public Works and Highways says 16 roads and bridges remain closed and impassable. The Cordillera region recorded the highest damage, amounting to 2.3 billion. With 10 of its roads still closed. Assessment and rehabilitation of the roads are underway. The DPWH also vowed to provide immediate assistance to affected communities. The Marcos administration is seeking over 540 billion pesos for climate mitigation and adaptation projects next year. Budget Secretary Amina Pangandaman says this is a 60% increase from the 2023 climate budget. Of this amount, 168 billion pesos will go to climate mitigation projects, while 370 billion will fund climate adaptation endeavors. Pangandaman also revealed government is working on an insurance program for state assets hit by disasters.
And on top of this, there are also foreign assisted projects under Koika. Or Korean Exim Bank. These two projects are the Pampanga Integrated Disaster and Risk Resiliency Project. And there's one more, yung Bulacan Angat Water Transmission Project. The Pampanga, it's a loan, so we just funded the government counterpart. So for the Pampanga, it's 1.397 billion yung government counterpart, and for Bulacan, it's 7.4 billion.
Let's get an update on the weather now from Pag-asa forecaster Lori De La Cruz. Good morning, Lori. What do you have for us?
Good morning, Nikki, and all our viewers and listeners. Southwest monsoon continues to affect Luzon. And with this, occasional rains will be experienced over Pangasinan, Zambales, and Bataan. So possible flooding or landslides due to moderate to heavy rains are expected. Cloudy skies with scattered rains and thunderstorms is also expected over Cordillera Administrative Region, Batanes, Babuyan Islands, Occidental Mindoro, and the rest of Ilocos Region and Central Luzon due to southwest monsoon. Meanwhile, here in Metro Manila and the rest of the country, improved weather will be experienced in the next 24 hours. Gale warning is also raised over the coastal areas of Batanes, northern coast of Ilocos Norte, and the northern coast of Cagayan, including Babuyan Islands. So fishing boats and other small sea craft are advised not to venture out into the sea, while larger sea vessels are alerted against big waves. That's the latest from Pag-asa. This is Lori De La Cruz.
Thank you, Lori. Good morning. The Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines confirms the wreckage of the missing Cessna plane has been found in the town of Luna in Apayao province. Now, the plane went missing Tuesday after departing from the Balawag International Airport. The crash site was found Thursday afternoon, around 50 kilometers from its destination, the Tuguegarao Airport. Rescuers have also recovered the bodies of the pilot and his student. A team of investigators was dispatched to look into the crash site. The Philippine Budget Secretary defends the increase in confidential and intelligence funds allocated in the government's 2024 spending plan. Budget Secretary Ambina Pangandaman says more confidential funds were given to agencies such as the ICT Department, the Anti-Money Laundering Council, and the Presidential Security Group. The proposed 9.2 billion pesos for confidential and intelligence funds for 2024 is 120 million pesos more compared to this year. But Pangandaman insists the amount is actually smaller in terms of the total share of the 5.77 trillion peso proposed budget 2024.
In 2018 po, ang share po ng CIF sa total national budget is 0.215%. 2023, 0.190%. And sa 2024 po, it's only 0.176. So it's the lowest po dun sa time series natin. So ibig sabihin po yung share po niya dun sa kabuuang budget natin, while you look at it, it's 10 billion pesos, it's actually ano po, decreasing naman po. Percentage. I think what it's important is that yung other sector na tumataas, yung confidential and intel mo bumababa. When you look at the budget, you look at the share of the different sectors dun sa total budget mo. So pag nakikita mo lumalaki yung social services, economic sector, and maybe general and yung defense, okay siya, di ba, compared to your CIF.
Philippine Budget Department believes a lot of benefits can be attained from the proposed 1.4 billion peso overseas travel budget of President Marcos Jr. for 2024. Now, the proposed amount is higher than the 893 billion peso budget for the president's foreign trips this year. President Marcos previously said he would cut down on his overseas travel and instead follow up on agreements signed during his previous trips.
Yung travel po ng presidente, dalawa pong klase yan. Meron pong state visit that they invite you. And then meron din po yung mga investment roadshow. So I think yung expenses po ng travel, as long as it will be beneficial and mas may advantage po para sa bansa natin, I think okay lang po yun.
In other news, 214 corporate officers of 127 local companies charged with tax evasion. The Philippine Tax Bureau says the tax violations range from failing to file income tax, withholding tax, and value-added tax returns, which all amount to 6.1 billion pesos. The agency did not disclose the names of the companies, but it said they come from various industries such as manufacturing, retail, importing, and construction. The BIR insists due process was observed prior to the filing of the cases and that companies either failed to provide sufficient documents to explain their non-filing or they did not respond to notices from the Bureau.
Gusto natin ng awareness sa mga taxpayers na kapag ka hindi nyo, pagka binaliwala ninyo ang proseso ng BIR ay ganito ang kahantungan ng inyong negosyo na malaki na agad ang pandarayang ginagawa niya na imbis na sa gobyerno na pupunta ay pinagkakakitaan ng mga negosyante ito.
Former Philippine Central Bank Governor Felipe Medalla was the highest paid government official in 2022. That's according to a report by state auditors, which evaluated the salaries of officials, members, and secretaries of various government agencies and corporations. Medalla's total salaries and allowances, gross of tax, amounted to 34.172 million pesos. He dethroned his predecessor, Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno, who held that spot in 2021. Now, the rest of the top 10 is completed by other central bank officials.